Nick here with Tiny Wood Stove, and I'm excited to show you around our Dwarf 5-kilowatt top baking oven. So this is kind of a test prototype before we start manufacturing, and we're going to take it outside and do a test burn fire. We're going to bake some cookies, and just want to show you around some of the features before we do that. So let's take a look.
So the oven sits on top of the 5-kilowatt, and the flue gases exit through the top of the stove, and then it goes around the chamber of the oven and then exit out the top, or optionally out the back. So you can, you know, if you want to use this whole top surface as a cooking area, you know, with a pan or a pot or a stock pot or whatever, you can exit out the back with a T and do that. If you have kind of a narrower footprint to install it, and I mean, you still have some cooking surface here, just not the whole area, you can optionally go out the top as well. So the oven measures, it's about nine inches deep, and it's about 11 and a half inches wide, and then you have these little shelves. So it comes with this stainless rack. And then this pan, a little parchment paper in there for our cookies. The pan, you know, can go on the different shelves. And then the oven will also fit, you know, an array of pans. Here's a pie tin. I think this is a 9-inch pie tin. Then we got an 8x8 casserole dish. We got a bread pan, and then a muffin tin, and all of these will, you know, fit in there. And you can fit, you know, a number of things configured in here at once. So you actually get a lot of baking area out of you know, a fairly small space. Okay, let's take it outside and fire it up.
All right, we drug this baby outside. It is cold out. I need to get my gloves on. It's probably, I don't know, it's less than 20 degrees. I don't have a really good spot to install this indoors right now, so we're just gonna do an outside test firing. Got my thermometer, got some fire starters. We're gonna fire it up and see how she does.
Okay, I got a little teepee built, and then I like to use these little wafer fire starters. They burn for a long time. You just tuck that in under there and it does its thing. And then the firebox will burn up to 10 to 12 inch logs. So this is a 10 inch log. And then we also have these are some North Idaho Energy logs. Basically they're just sawdust, highly, highly compressed. Nothing else is added, but they have really high BTU. So a big log, which is double this, will burn 8 hours. So this will do 4 hours. And we typically will chunk these up into smaller bits, about 2 hour chunks, and add it into the 4-kilowatt. The 5-kilowatt, you mean, you could easily add one or two of these. Okay, let's get this little wafer going. I got the wafer going, and I have the door still cracked just to kind of let that take. This is our version 1.0 of the Dwarf 5-kilowatt. You'll notice this secondary air take. We replaced that with basically a different port in the back of the stove so that it's controlled from one valve. That makes it a lot easier to operate. Plus, it allows us to direct the direct air box, so you're piping in both the primary and secondary. This way, you'd still be using cabin air from that. So as that starts to take a little bit more, we can probably shut the door. And we have the air wash about halfway open, secondary halfway, and we have the primary full. All right, a little log cabin was taken off, so we added another chunk of
kind of kindling in there.
We'll let that go to a decent coal bed, and then we'll add some larger fuel. Seems to be drafting pretty good. It is smoking, you know, a bit right now. I'd assume until we get, you know, get some heat in the firebox there, it's going to be smoking a bit. We'll fine tune the the draft with the air intake too. Okay, so stove's been going for about 5 minutes. Went ahead and opened up all the air intakes just to get it roaring. And some of the paint starting to off gas a little bit and set. It's probably a good idea when you get, before installing it in a space, to take it out like we are and just put a chunk of pipe in it and just let that paint cure, because that does, you know, off gas a little bit until it sets. All right, we've been burning for about 20 minutes here. The interior temp, I mean, it has no problem heating up. Thermometer works a little better when it's kind of not so close to the glass, maybe closer to the heat. But everything is, I don't know if you can see some of that kind of smoke coming off. Everything's still kind of curing. And so I'm just gonna put a couple more little rounds in and let it slowly burn and just let some of that paint and stuff cure off before we toss some cookies in there. Some quick temperatures. So this bottom plate here, yeah, it's 600 degrees. The back, 580, and the side walls, 375. And then top, 230. That probably takes a bit more to heat up. We got side wall, 389. Get the back here, 500, 375. All right, let it do its thing for a bit and then toss some cookies in. All right, we've been burning for about 40 minutes and I've been keeping this open occasionally just to let some of that, some of those fumes come out, but it doesn't take very long for it to heat up. So right now it's just under 400 degrees and I had that open up for a little bit. And see that secondary air kicking in there. When you open up the door, it's best just to give it a little crack before busting it just wide open so that it's not, you don't get a bunch of smoke coming out. I'm gonna give it maybe another 10 minutes or so. Maybe leave this open. And then we're gonna put some cookies in there. All right, time to toss some cookies in there. It's definitely putting out some smoke and our pipe is not getting super hot. And I wonder if that's partially because we're outside and it's not insulated, so those flue gases are cooling down too rapidly. I mean, I think it would definitely make a difference if you were inside. Well, let's toss cookies in. There's definitely an art to wood stove baking. I've never done it. I've heard that you can manage oven temperatures, you know, with your fire. Plus, just kind of cracking the door. So we'll see what it looks like here for our cookies. All right, it's been over just over 8 minutes, and they're still looking a little doughy, and I probably should have cracked the door because that heat was creeping up, probably a little too hot. So I'm gonna just kind of crack that a little bit and see if I can get them to bake the setup just a little bit. So I went ahead and rotated the pan. It looked like the ones that were in the back were getting a little more crispier. And I'm gonna leave them in there for about another 2 minutes and just let it crack. Okay, I think I might have put them in just for a little too long. Let them kind of finish setting up on the pan, take them in, but otherwise, not bad. There she is, a perfectly baked chocolate chip cookie. I had to do a little rotating. I think the oven will take a little bit of perfecting as far as skill goes, but not bad. Put a little kettle on top, see if we can boil some water. The stove is burning much, much cleaner since getting really a good hot bed of coals. No smoke coming out anymore. And the flue pipe, though, is still too cold. I think that's probably partially just because it's freaking cold outside. And obviously inside it wouldn't have an issue, and then outside you'd have insulated pipe. So, yeah, all in all, it's drafting well. The oven heats up awesome. Super pleased.